Shut up and sit down.
Global warming speech. Speech on global warming for students and children in English. Global warming is an international phenomenon where the Earth's mean surface temperature is increasing rapidly due to the accumulation of greenhouse gases in the atmosphere. The source of these greenhouse gases is various, both natural and man-made, such as forest fires, industrialization, burning of crops, burning of fossil fuels, etc. Global warming has proved to be a huge force created by man that can have the potential to destroy the natural cycle of our planet. Global warming is not a recent phenomenon, but it has surely improved and increased because of rapid industrialization, population explosion, agricultural explosion, and the ever-increasing greed for economic growth for countries at the cost of exploiting our environment. Global warming did exist hundreds of years before when civilization began to occur. There are examples of burning fossil fuels and causing pollution even during early civilizations like the Indus Valley Civilization or Harappan Civilization. But the magnitude of global warming today is 1,000 times more than what it was a few centuries back. Some of the main greenhouse gases that are causing global warming are carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, sulfur hexafluoride, hydrofluorocarbons, and perfluorocarbons. Most of the greenhouse gases are produced due to the consumption of fossil fuels. The effects of global warming are plenty, and one of the most catastrophic effects of global warming is the deterioration of the ozone layer. Due to the accumulation of chlorofluorocarbons in the stratosphere, scientists have predicted that an area above the continent of Antarctica has a huge ozone hole. The ozone layer is a layer in the atmosphere which protects the Earth's surface from the harmful ultraviolet radiation coming from the sun. When this ozone layer gets depleted, the living beings on the planet Earth is easily exposed to UV rays. This can cause catastrophic effects on human health, the agricultural cycle, the climatic cycle, and the very existence of our planet. Let me mention a few of the impacts of global warming that we are already seeing. The year 2020. It is due to global warming that there is a rise in sea levels, which is causing flooding of patches of lands, the low-lying settlers and islands countries of Indonesia and Japan. Global warming is causing changes in rainfall patterns. When the change in rainfall patterns and climatic changes occurs abruptly, it becomes difficult for the meteorological departments to predict natural calamities, and this increases the damage caused to life and property. Droughts, forest fire floods, and earthquakes are some of the indications of changes in climatic patterns caused due to global warming. Melting of glaciers and polar ice caps has caused almost extinction of habitat near the North Pole and the South Pole. The polar bears, which are considered to be greatly endangered species, are decreasing in their population by the day because of the melting of glaciers. The melting of glaciers can also lead to an increase in floods and famine in the nearby regions. Certain diseases like malaria are caused due to global warming, since there is the migration of species from one place to another. Many scientists also predict that the COVID-19 pandemic that we are witnessing in the year 2020 can also be traced back to the impact of global warming when seen from the bird's point of view. I would like to conclude my global warming speech by saying that the international community, governments and citizens have to come forward to reduce their carbon footprint to save the planet for our future generation. All of us living here are the stakeholders of nature, and we are responsible for how we take care of our environment. As the saying goes, charity begins at home. We have to start using biodegradable materials in our houses, reduce plastic waste and other such changes in our lifestyle so that we can make an impact to reduce global warming globally.